Yeah, I just want to take an opportunity to introduce this old man here that is staying behind with me. This one is Pastor Lino Chibanti. He's almost over 76 years old, and he's a guy staying here in Sanje, and the man has got a story to share with us, almost three stories. Then one who tell us the story about when he was over there at the mountain. Then the after, as I saw another story whereby he prayed for a baby. Then the after he was going also to tell us a story on how he received the call of God. Then at the meantime, I just want to ask Pastor Lino so that he may tell us the story when he climbed over there at the mountain.
In the Segurina, in Lino, 1976, Dinanya Muka, who Peter would feed within the gas, and the Dakara in Yumbamanga do Sava Gudia 3 days. Then the number Mau, Yogra Gumamba.
Myself, Lino Chibanti, there was a time whereby I fasted for 3 days in my house. Later, I heard a voice.
The
Lord said to me, I know that you are fasting for 3 days.
Then I'm
asking you to climb the mountain, then you fast for 3 days as well. When I climbed over there, the mountain, I fasted for 3 days. Then I also heard a voice that this is not enough. You need not to break your fasting. You need to continue with the fasting with another 3 days. Then now it's 9 days fasting without eating anything over there at the mountain. Later, I become thirsty. Then I tried to come down a little bit and see where I can get water. But I could not be able to find water anymore. Then I was like, I was fainted because I was too thirsty. Now when I sat down, then what I do, I finally passed the urine through my own hands. Then I drank my own urine. Then I could hear the voice that the passing urine that I drank is flowing over my body. Then I heard another voice. You can do nothing with my servant. Thereafter, I got strength then. Then I started a solo climbing over there at the mountain. Then I reached at the right place. I could not able that I could find water over there. Then I find water somewhere. Then I started drinking. When I rested, then I thought of breaking the fasting, then coming back home.
So kunyumba anthu anali kudanda adali kulira kuti amene wapita kuti 9 days.
Now at home, the wife and the children were surprising, saying, where is this guy has gone? For 9 days, he's nowhere to be seen. Then as they were negotiating, looking for me, then they saw me coming down from the mountain. When I reached home,
Dina pesa madzi ndikumwa.
Then I find water, then I drank again.
Ndipo thupi ndiyamba kukhala ndi yamphamvu.
Then I get strengthened.
Ndipo ichi ndi choyamba changa chimene ndidakumana nacho.
This is my first testimony that I experienced while I was fasting for 9 days at the mountain.
Why was he fasting? Ask him that question.
Chifukwa ninji kapena chida kupangitsa ninji chani kuti musale kudya. What made you to fast actually? What was your problem?
Budo langa inali hotele. Ndidali kupemphelera munthu ndikuchira. Ndinali kupemphelera munthu ndikuchira. So bano nditaona kuti ndapemphelera wina sadachide ndinkati mwamoyo mwanga. Mkati mwamoyo mwanga ndinaganizira ndikwere kuphiri ndikapemphere kuti mphamvu ibwererenso mkati mwanga.
What made me actually to arrange this program to go into fasting is this. Myself, I was gifted in healing. Wherever I'm laying hands on sick people, instantly the healing is taking place. But I was surprised one day when I prayed with somebody but he did not get healed. Then I realized in my spirit that maybe I've missed it somehow, somewhere. And the way that I'm sensing the flowing of the presence of the Lord is not the same at first. It seems like the anointing is drying up. Therefore, I thought of going back to the mountain and seek the face of God for the restoration of that power of healing to start operating in my life.
Amen.
Hallelujah.